Mars, ancient water hotspot. NASA's Opportunity rover has found another spot where warm water may have flowed or percolated on Mars long ago, researchers have announced. Opportunity made the find while studying a rock on the rim of Mars' huge Endeavour crater. The rock, called Tisdale II, has unusually high levels of zinc and bromine, elements often deposited by water, especially hot water. The rock is unlike anything else ever seen up close on Mars, researchers say. On Earth, life just needs water and energy to get a foothold, and hydrothermal systems teem with microbes. Such sites are thus good places to look for evidence of ancient life on Mars, which is cold and dry today. And water is life. So, in essence, or in other words, they have found life on Mars. Because there can be no life as we know it without water. And Mars is a future new Earth for humankind. Opportunity's twin rover, Spirit, discovered strong evidence of an ancient hydrothermal system near its landing site back in 2007. While researchers are still studying Opportunity's data, they think Endeavour's rim might well harbor another one. When you find rocks on Earth that are rich in zinc, they typically formed in a place where you had some kind of hydrothermal activity going on, said the principal investigator for Spirit and Opportunity's mission. This is a clue that we may be dealing with a hydrothermal system here, a cradle for life. Endeavour is a giant impact crater approximately 14 miles or 22 kilometers across. Opportunity just arrived at its rim on August 9th at a site called Cape York. The region looks completely different from other parts of Mars that Spirit and Opportunity have explored, researchers said. Tisdale II, which is about the size of a footstool, is the first rock the rover has examined in detail at the crater. So, researchers stressed, their investigation is still preliminary. They can't yet say for certain that Opportunity has uncovered a long-dead hydrothermal system, but it's a real possibility. Further, this system might be even more exciting than the one Spirit found 4 years ago. The warm water in that system was likely to have been very acidic. So was a lot of the other water bubbling out of the Martian ground long ago, both near Spirit's site and near Opportunity's site. But the rocks and soil around Endeavour might be more neutral and thus more benign, researchers said. NASA spacecraft orbiting Mars have gathered compelling evidence that there are clay minerals in their area, and clay minerals don't form in acidic conditions. So, if there really are clay minerals present, as we suspect there are, then that points to water with a very different chemistry, water that's more neutral, and conditions that would have been more suitable for life. A hydrothermal system doesn't necessarily mean flowing water, but hot water vapor may have also moved through the rocks long ago. The heat to power this system may have come from the impact that created Endeavour. Just getting started, researchers hope to flesh out just what's going on at Endeavour over the coming weeks and months. Opportunity, after all, has only just begun studying the giant crater. Amazingly, after 7 years and 8 months, we're embarked on a brand new mission, said Ray Arvidson, the rover mission's deputy principal investigator at Washington University in St. Louis. Opportunity and Spirit landed on Mars in January 2004 on what was planned to be just a three-month mission to search for signs of past water activity on Mars. Both robots delivered in a big way, finding lots of evidence that the Red Planet was a much wetter, warmer place in the ancient past. The twin rovers long outlasted their warranties. Spirit stopped communicating with Earth in March 2010, and NASA announced the rover dead this past May. Opportunity, however, is still going strong. It has now covered 20.8 miles, 33.5 kilometers on the Martian surface, more than 30 times its original distance objective. Opportunity is showing some signs of its advanced age. Mission engineers have been driving the rover backward for the last few years, for example, to distribute the wear more evenly among the rover's gear mechanisms. But the rover keeps chugging along, and it finally reached Endeavour, which has been its targeted destination since August 2008. The mission team is excited to start studying the crater's environs in detail. They say this has the potential to be the most revealing destination ever explored by Opportunity, said the program executive for NASA's Mars Exploration Rovers at NASA headquarters in Washington. This region is substantially different than anything we've seen before. Yes, Mars has water, and water is life. Water is a part of the physical manifestation of the Creator, and it is a part of the Holy Spirit. Mars is a part of the future of humanity. This too is another sign of the end times, transition days, which is a day-by-day process of extraordinary changes, happenings, and events. Everything is connected, and everything is numbered, because it's about what kind of world are we leaving to the future generations. Genesis chapter 1. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth and everything else. 2. And the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep, and the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. 3. And God said, Let there be light, and there was light. 4. And God saw the light, but it was good, and God divided the light from the darkness. 5. And God called the light day, and the darkness he called night, and the evening and the morning were the first day. 6. And God said, Let there be a firmament in the midst of the waters, and let it divide the waters from the waters. 7. And God made the firmament, and divided the waters which were under the firmament from the waters which were above the firmament. And it was so. 8. And God called the firmament heaven, and the evening and the morning were the second day. 9. And God said, Let the waters under the heaven be gathered together unto one place, and let the dry land appear. And it was so. It's time for all prophecy to be fulfilled, and this is what I see, think, and feel. Mars is a part of our future. Someday, humans will go there, and they will live there. And this is also a prophecy